As I was afraid when I make a tutorial, it became very long and it doesn't convert to a video file. That is because I am going, I cannot sit and write the codes, which take time, but I am going to go through. In this tutorial, I am going through the rings and how we can fill the items or elements, and I am going through the we are going to change color, and we are going to change font and color of a text. We are going to use binary switch together with timer, and we are going to make more extra panels. As you know, when you start the program, a panel automatically starts, then you design your project. But maybe you need another panel to call new panel, and we are going to use this thing in this tutorial. And we are going to use a custom text box and custom ring, and at last we are going through the progress bar. For this, you are going on the start lab windows. Start a new project from template and give it a name and replace it any place you want in your computer, and select OK. I have already started an example too, and my example, I have designed the part one, an icon of a type command button OK, and double clicked on it and use a callback part one and change the label also as part one. And I have replaced a ring, use a ring and a ring. And I have double clicked on it to use fill the variable, and because it must appear in set control attribute in C file. Here under set control attribute, use control P. And the command button, use the command button color, and also you can also use a label color. It is also okay if you want it. I can do that. And to get the values, you have all those values, and it's the key code. All of them are here. You can copy and paste in a text file, and you can fill your because all those labels, values, it is all those values are valid, and you must fill it. I have copied and pasted in the in a notepad, and I have a field in this. I have used the colors and the value here in this ring is an integer, and it's beginning from 0, and it is 9 colors. I have used it, and it is from 0 to 8. It's okay. And here in this program under part 1 callback, you need two integers, one color and one array of integers. The array of integers is all those values you find it inside that set control attribute, and I have copied and pasted and move it here. What is important is the color must match with the same name. It must be with the same label. They must be in the same order. Okay. I have 9 colors and here is, and we are going to inside the event, we are going to get control val the panel ring, the ring item, and put it because we get it is an integer, and we are going to put it an integer color. And then we are going to set control attribute of a panel command of a command button, and we are going to change its color to that color we have here. We have it here. And I have used absolute value because some of them are going to convert it as negative value. And I am going to set pause because the values are not exactly. Now the values are correct. I have 9 values here, and we are going to run. The default value is var red, and I'm going to press and it appears surround red. I am going to change it as green. I am going, you can change it by arrow while you can use it here, cyan, and you can use black. It's black and it is gray, and it is gray, and you are going to use blue. And it is blue surround. Okay. Here I can use Control P and change it as a label star label color. Uko Control I replace, and we are going to run to see if it happening something. Red, it is red. You can use blue, it is blue. You can use magenta, it is magenta. It is black, it is black. And we are going to use white, it is white. And you are going to use black, and it is black. Okay, it works. In second step, I am going to use another function of ring. I am going to put a part 2, and I am going to use the same ring, and I am going to select callback on that. And in C, I am going to use, this time I am going to call color as array of character and integer I, and here instead I am going to get control index of the ring, the index, it is the value, and I'm going to put it inside an integer and get label from index, which index we have chosen. you are going to put it in the color. And I am going to get a message to get us which color we have used it. When I run this one, I am going to use part 2. It is wall red. I am going to use blue. It is wall blue. I am going to use yellow. It is wall yellow. I am going to use white. It is white. And I am going to use black. It is black. Okay. The next step is that I am going to use a bottom part 3. I call it part 3. And I am going to double click on it and use a callback function part 3. And I am going to replace a new ring and put it here. And inside that callback, when I use a generate callback, inside it I am going to declare two variables, one an array of character buff and another font int. And inside that one I am going to double click on ring, and on the value I am going to use an empty label with value 0. The next, and I am using, after that I am using below and select get a label name bold, and its value is 1, and then italic, and then color uko. And inside here I am going to use get control val from ring 2, the second ring here. The second ring, I am going to put its value in the integer, because when I use get control val, the value is an integer, and I'm going to put an integer variable. And I'm going to get a val of string. Yes, I need an string here. I use text string, and I use here, and I put something here after that. And I need also a text box. And I am going to get something I have written in a string and set the control attribute of text box to the bold. If when I choose something here, bold, italic, color, and I put a name or a phrase or something, then I am going to check the font, make a switch font. And case 1, if it is the first value, the value is 1, then you are going, it is bold, and you are going to set control attribute of text box to the bold, and the value is 1. It means that you are going to change it to the bold, and you are going to set in text box what you have take it from a string and put it in buff, and then you are going to add a new line. The case 2 is italic, and in set control attribute you are going to select the text box and use the text as italic, and you are going to get a value 1, and you are going to set the text box as the buffer, and use new line. And as default, the default value, it is number 3, which is the color, and you are going to change the text color, and I have used a wild green, and you are going to put the what is in the buffer to the text box and use a new line. Now we are going to run it, and I am going to use hello there, and I am using bold, and I am pressing it up here, bold here, and then I am going to use how is it, and I am choosing italic and use it there, and everything in text box is changed to the italic, and then I am going to use I am okay and use color, which is the last, the default value, and I am going to use part 3, and everything here has changed its color. Now we are going to use a binary switch. It is binary switch. I have chosen that one, and I am double clicking on it, double click it on it, and change the label from untitled control to part 4 and move it here, and I am going to replace a timer and double clicking on it and change the label as untitled control to part 4, and I am using a callback function, timer callback, and I am going to generate this, and in this in C source it appeared the event timer tick, which I want, and I declared few variables, a character S1 with length 10, an integer KJID event panel, and a global variable called KK equal 0. And inside the case, I am going to get the value of binary switch and put it on our local variable K. And I am starting a for loop until K is 1. And I am going to start and delay, otherwise the program is going very, very quick. And I am going to start a delay without any statement. I am going to start a delay without any statement. And after that delay, I am going to fill my string with a deformat comma space. And I am going to increment KK, which was 0 from the beginning. And I'm going to put the value inside my text box with the same value I have written in S1. And I am going to get user event of my event panel, and inside that ID. What is going to do is that we have an event here, and it is going to you to put a value inside event panel and inside that its ID. And if ID is a panel binary switch, then I am going to change the value of K0, because here I am going to use that one. And then I am going again to get a value from binary and put it in the K. Now I am running. The default value is off. Now I am going to on, and it appears 1, 2, 3, 4 after each second. then you use off, it's a stop, continue, stop, and when I am going, it continue from that pause or stop. I am going to stop again, and I am going to run again, and it appear, then it works. Okay, the next step is to make a panel. You are going to use that icon and it appear a panel, another panel, and here custom panel, you are change it to pan. It is panel, you are going to change it to pan. And you are going to save the panel as example2_1 UER, and inside that panel you are going to use a command button OCO and double click on it and use it OCO1 callback, and don't change label, you don't need change label, but you are going to use a text message inside here. And you are going to use a generate control back, and inside your C file, you are going to define a pan as a static integer panel handle pan. And here under the panel handle, you are going to copy and paste and change the panel handle to pan. And use its UER, it's that one, the new one you have used it, and everything is as the same. But here under discard panel handle, you must discard pan 2. And what is happening in part 5? We are going to get, you are going to use a string here, and a string, and put it there, and you are going to write something, and here you are going to get the value and put it in our character S, and you are going to display, you are going to call the panel, you are going to call this panel. And in this panel, you are going to set the value in this panel, you are going to set the inside the text message what you have read it in the first panel, in the main panel. And when you switch, when you press UCO button, you are going to hide the panel pan. When you want use that one, use Control P, and here instead of panel handle, you are writing pan, and inside here you are going to select that one. That one you must select to find the panel text message. And I am going to run. Hi, new panel. And I am going to use part 1. And it appear our new panel. And it is hi new panel. And you press OK. It hide it. You can use another. I check again and it appear I check. Okay, then it is work. In the next step, I am going to make a custom text box in another panel. Then I am using that icon, new user interface file, or under file, new user interface UER, and I am going here at the right, it stands panel, but you are going to change it to pan 2, and you are going to only put a echo button, and callback function is echo toes callback, and you are going to save it as example to underline two, and then you are going to in UER you are going to use part 6 and icon of type echo, change its label and put the part 6 as callback function, and you are going to use generate callback, and then here you are going to use generate callback, and inside here you are going inside that part 6 you are going to use text box control, but before that you are going to define it as global variable text box control, and you are going here put the that condition while with pound 2 and example to underline 2 UER, and also discard part 2 you are going to add in your project. And under part 6 you are going to make a custom control text box control and use new control and select control P, and instead of panel handle you are going to use pan 2, and the control style you are going to scroll down to text box here, and then you are going to give it a label text box control or something like that, and you are going to replace it in the middle of your new panel, and I have given it top 100, left 100, and I am going to use control I and use replace, but I am going to use control Z because I have it already, and after that I am going to display panel pan 2, which make it that you can see the panel, and when you press echo it's going to, you are going to write something in that text box you have made it, and you are going to get its context from that text box control and put it in an S, which is an array of character, and you are going to hide the panel 2 and start and show panel 3 and set and put what you have read taken from panel 2 and put it in the panel 3 with text message. Also you are going to create again a second panel and save it as example to underline 3 and put a text message and put a echo button and call it echo 3 callback and generate it, and here when you select the echo in the panel 2 it opens this panel and it put what you have take it from that custom text box and put it here, and when you use echo it's going to hide panel 3. Now we are running the program and you are going selecting part 6, it appear our text box here, it works, and select UCO, and it appear panel 3, and your it stands what you have written in another panel, and when you use UCO, it hide the panel. You can use the game part, and you can use hello new panel, UCO, and it appear hello new panel, and you are going to hide it. The next step is how we can make a custom ring. I define, declare a global variable ring control in the static int, and I am going to scroll down and I am going to use ring control equal new control, and you're going to use control P. This one is in my main panel, and the style is ring lab style, and the label it's ring control, and the position here it is from here there, and I am moving this icon here, which is part 7, and at the right I can see size position, and the left is 248 and the top is 51, and I'm going to use here 53 250, and it is okay. And in our you have put it and use control I, and then you put the command buttons UCO, change the label as part 7, and use a callback function part 7, and use generate callback, and inside it I have used defined my custom ring control, and after that, because it is a ring type, then you must put the items inside, and for this I am using insert list item of panel handle and my ring control, and the first index is 0, and I call it open, and the item value is 1, and I copy paste, and I used the index -1 and call it save as, and the value is 2. Then I paste again and change it to close, and the value is 3. Then paste again. The next label is exit, and the value is 4. And then I am using another icon and call it go, and double click go callback and generate it, and when I select that go, it's going to get control index. It's taking the ring index, my custom ring index, and put it in an integer which I have declared here, and get label from index. Its label E of I, of what I have get it here, and put it in variable S, which is an array of characters, and then I am going to write a message in a message pop-up, and the title is info, but the value is s. Now we are going to run. When I select this part 7, it appear my ring control, my custom ring control, and I can change the values by this arrow or only select on it and you save as go. It appear a pop-up frame and it is save as UCO. I am going to change it as exit. It is exit UCO, and I am going to change it as open. It appear open, and I am going to change as close, and it is closed. Okay, then it is work. The next step is our progress bar. I am going to put a command button and call it part 8 as callback function and part 8 as label, and I am going to use a tooltip custom controls, tools lib controls, and progress bar. And I am going to use here, and I am going to delete the its title control label, and I am going to press generate the part 8, and inside here I am going to use functions. But before we use it, under in the left in the tree, you are going to select the project example 2, right click and use add existing file. And you are going to scroll down under C, program files, national instrument, CVI, tools lib, cost control, and you are going to scroll down until progress bar, and you select it and use OK, cancel, and it appear instrument files progress bar FP. And here you can write progress bar, and you can see here that you have progress bars functions, and it is create, convert from slide, which is very important, and you are going to scroll up in your main function. After those if and before display panel, you are going to put your mouse cursor and select this one and double click. It appeared a function here, it appeared that window, and use your panel from here. Set variable panel handle UCO, and here you are going to use in your main UER and select panel progress bar, and use control I, and use control I, and then inside your part 8 callback, you are going to use that function set attribute, and here it appears opens that that frame, and here you are using the panel handle and then panel progress bar, and you are going to change the color. You are going to change the color to green. I have used wall green. You can change it as wall blue, and control I replace. And again, you are going to select the progress bar set attribute And here, when it the window is open, here you are going to select the mark speed and OCO, and the value, the default value is 300, and I have used it 100, and the value is a double of a type double, then it must be 100.0. Then I am going to make a loop with a variable of float, I equals 0.0, I less than 100.0, and I plus equal 0.1. And each step I am going to increment the variable I with 0.1, and I am going to use that set progress bar set percentage, and I am going to use I here and leave it the label empty. When I am going to run, and press part 8, it appear, it's appear, how it has gone. You can also use the set total time estimate or get total time estimate, but it is not necessary. Okay, it is all in this tutorial. I hope that you have learned how you can take care of panels and the rings and make a custom component and also progress bar. It was all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.